everyone, this is Angela, and this is my second Stitch With Me video. I'm gonna do a tag while I stitch, so I hope you enjoy this video and you get some stitching done while listening to me or watching. I'm gonna do the original cross stitch tag. I was going to do the Know Your Needleworker tag, but then I did it last year, but I deleted those videos. And I couldn't find the Know Your Needleworker tag. So I contacted Michelle Bendy on Instagram, and she gave me this link to the left-handed stitcher blog. I'll have a link up on the screen if anybody's interested. But she had a lot of other tags, so I decided to do a different one. It's called the original cross stitch tag. So there's 15 questions, so I'm gonna go through them right now. Before that, I'm stitching I'm stitching the Rose Quaker by I don't think I could pronounce that. But it's called Rose Quaker. I got this from 123 Stitch. But right now I am on the second row and I'm doing this motif. Roses are my favorite flowers, so when I saw this, I really liked it, so I got it right at the spot. But I am doing this 1/1, but I'm doing the tenth stitch or the half stitch. It's really tiny. This is on 28 count even weave by Picture This Plus called Petals, I think. I wanted to do 2/2 with the full cross, but I didn't have the right size fabric and I really wanted to start it. So I just decided to try the 1/1 half stitch. And I think I really like it. And the coverage looks fine. Like this area right here, if you could see that. It looks fine. But one thing that I don't like about the half stitch is that, like this design right here, because it's a half stitch, this side and this side doesn't match. So I thought about changing the stitch direction on this side, but then I don't know, I just decided not to. And if you see it from far away, it doesn't really matter, but then I keep noticing it. So I don't know if I should, like this right here too. That should be like a motif where there's a diagonal line all the way through, but I'm doing a half stitch, so it looks like I don't even know how to describe that, but I don't know. What do you guys think? Does that bother you? Should I take that out? But it's 1/1 half stitch and I really don't want to frog those. But let me know what you think. From far away, you can't really tell there's a difference, I don't think. But just let me know if you have any ideas or comments about that. But anyways, I'm gonna start the tag now. So number one, how did you start or who introduced you to cross stitch? That's actually a funny story because there isn't a story. Nobody remembers in my family when or who taught me how to cross stitch. It's just one day I was already stitching. I started cross stitching really young, so I don't even remember who taught me or what my first project was. But my earliest memory of cross stitching is when my dad used to travel a lot for work, and he brought me this small tiny kit. I think it was like a Disney kit, so you could stitch it and then you can make it into a keychain. The whole thing came with the kit, the keychain and the floss and the fabric. It wasn't even Aida, it was like this rubbery type thing where you stitch it and you can like kind of pull it too, and it's all like rubber. rubbery, and I think it was made out of silicone or silicone. I'm not really sure. And I don't even remember the image, like the design of that keychain. But the one that I do remember is, well, actually, I don't even remember that one. It was my sixth grade graduation in Korea. I got this, the whole kit. I kit the whole thing up with the floss box, the floss, the chart, and needles, and I didn't have a hoop or a Q-snap or anything. I just stitched in hand. But it cost me, well, in American dollars, I think it was about $50. In Korean Korean won, it's 50,000 won. And that's a lot of money for a sixth grader to spend. And I thought I would get in trouble if my parents found out. So I kept it in my school locker. And then when it was graduation day, I thought I would get in trouble when I had to clear my things out, because my parents were there for the graduation event. So I gave the whole kit to my friend, and I don't even remember who I gave it to or what the design was. And all I did for that, I remember, is I think I bobbinated all of the threads, but I didn't put one stitch in it. And later I told my parents about it, like a couple of years ago, and my mom and dad thought that was so silly. But yeah, that was a long answer, but I don't remember who taught me, because nobody in my family stitches. Not even my grandmothers do any kind of embroidery or needlework. I heard my mom's mom, so my mom's side grandma, she used to do some needlework, but she was too old to do anything. I'm so sad to say that, but yeah, she wasn't interested in any type of needlework or anything like that. So that's my answer for number one. Number two, do you have a favorite theme or designer? I like a lot of designers. Well, the first designer that I recently was obsessed with was Brooks Books Publishing. And then I got a lot of her charts, like all the Spirit series. And then I got, oh, recently I got something, but I don't remember what it's called. Maybe I'll show you in one of my other videos later on. But anyways, I have a lot of her charts. I have the whole Alice in Wonderland series, which I still haven't finished. But, and then I think I really like Mirabilia's. At first I thought it wasn't really my style, but then I ended up getting like 10 last year. And I'm on my second Mirabilia, the stone roses, the one you saw on my other Stitch With Me video. My first one was Fairy Idol. That was a huge project. I didn't realize how big that was. It took me a while for me to finish that. But if you want to see that, let me know. I'll do a close-up of that finish. But other than that, I like a lot of designers. I don't think I stick to one type of style or designer. I just like what I like when I see them. So I guess I'll go to number three now. What floss brand do you use? DMC. I don't collect any of the other branded, not branded, but the hand-dyed silks or floss. First of all, it's hard to get that from here. I have to order it, and it takes a long time, and then I sometimes don't trust the postal service here. So, but 123 Stitch, their package come in real quick. So maybe if I do get them, I'll try 1, 2, 3 stitch. But for right now, I'm mostly using DMC, and for Mirabilia's, I would get the special flosses. Or actually, in Korea, we have this one website where I could get them, but I don't really change the design or the floss colors of the chart. So yeah, I just stick with what they're called for. So just DMC. Oh, I think I went too far. I thought it was all the way up to here, but I gotta take that out. Okay, number 4. What is your fabric of choice? Right now I'm stitching on even weave, but I like to stitch on linen. I like the irregularity on linen, so that's what I mostly use. And I like Aida too, because it makes your stitches look real nice, but I don't like how stiff it is. So yeah, linen. Number 5, do you use a needle threader, or are you a floss licker? Neither. I don't. If I do have to choose, I think I would just lick my floss. I don't really care about that. But usually I don't have to lick or do anything with the threads. I don't have any problems threading my needles. Next question. What kind of stitching frame do you use? Well, right now I'm using a Q-snap, but I also use the scroll rods with the Velcro by American Dream Stan. But recently I started to like the Q-snaps better because it's easier. I don't like to deal with the Velcro and all the other stuff. So Q-snap, I think. Or sometimes I use hoops too, but I don't like the hoop marks. So yeah, Q-snaps. Number 7. How many projects have you finished? I don't know. Well, I stopped stitching when I was in college, and I started stitching kind of seriously last year, I think, or 2015 or 16. Yeah, 2016 I restarted. So since then I could count it, but before that I have no idea. But let me check if I could. So this is the planner that I use. It's by Filofax. Yeah, Filofax. And I have all of the finishes and whips written down here. So let me see if I could find them. Okay, so in 2017, these are my finishes. So it looks like I had 16 last year, but there are 4, 5 Brooks books, the Wonderland series, but I'm doing all of that in one fabric. So if you count that as one and not finished, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 finishes in 2017. And this year so far, I have 4 finishes. Is that right? I feel like I have more. Yeah, I have more because I finished the Snow White by Brooks Books and Belle, the dress collection. The dress collection, is that what it's called? But I finished those two this year. And then, oh no, wait. Oh, so Belle, I did it last year. So I counted them wrong. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 finishes, including Belle last year. And the Brooks Books Wonderland series, I finished 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of those. Or, yeah, 5 of those. But that's all in one fabric, like I said. So if you don't count that, I have... Yeah, I have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I don't know. I'm trying to count, but I can't read my own handwriting. So it's 9 or 10 last year. And this year, there should be more than 4. But that's all I have written down right now. But if you want to see my finishes, let me know in my comments. Then I'll do a separate video of that. So next question. Number eight, how many completed works do you have currently displayed in your home? I think I have 2 displayed. But they're not like framed or anything. I just have them like tacked on to like a form or foam board. Is that what it's called? Like those soft board things? And it's a Christmas tree. But we still have that in our display case. And we haven't put that away. It's still in there. But I have that in our living room. And then in my room, I have the Mill Hill kit. I think it's called Moonstruck. I could show you that right now. It's a little dusty because it's been sitting there, but this is the Mill Hill frame that I got from 123 Stitch that was made made for that design. Not that design, but those Mill Hill kits. But I want to frame more projects. I have a lot of them in hangers in my room, but I haven't had the time or money to get them framed. And I don't really trust my local, I don't even know if they are local framers. But I feel like they're gonna mess it up. But yes, I have 2. On display right now. Number 9. Do you do more stitching for gifts or keep them for yourself? I keep them for myself. I don't know anybody around me who stitches I don't think anybody knows that I stitch except for my family. I don't really talk about cross-stitching to my other friends. So, yeah, I don't cross-stitch as gifts or anything like that. But if there is somebody who appreciates the time that goes into it, of course, I don't mind. I would want to stitch something for them. But right now, I haven't. Well, I did one for my mom when I used to be in the States. I used to live in California, and my parents were in Korea, and it was her birthday. So I did a small happy birthday, mom, or I love you, mom card, I think. And it was a very horrible made card, but my mom liked it. So I think that's all that matters. Actually, I made one for my dad too. His zodiac animal, is it zodiac animal? Or zodiac sign is a rooster. So I made him a rooster when I was in high school. It was one of the designs in the cross stitch magazines. I don't know which one, but it was on Ada, and It had a lot of colors and it was really pretty. I kept saying it was a chicken, and my dad corrected me. But anyways, so I did one for my mom, one for my dad. Let me just mark my chart real quick. Okay, next question. What is your favorite project or finish you are most proud of? As for now, Fairy Idol by Mirabilia, just because it was so big, and it took a lot of time, and I really liked that design. I just like the whole layout of that design, like the plant over the fairy figure and the chandelier and the stone statues. I think that design is so pretty. And I'm actually thinking about doing another one similar to that design. It's called Roses of Sharon, I think. Or something like that. That one's really pretty too. I also have that design. So it will be like a companion piece when I frame it. I think I wanna frame that right next to each other or hang it next to each other. And I think it'll look really pretty. Number 11. What has been your least favorite or worst experience while stitching? I don't think I have any. I don't remember feeling bad about something while stitching. Well, or I could tell you about how obsessed I was about how my stitches looked. I did the Cinderella dress collection, or the dress-up one by Brooks Books last year, and I really didn't like how my stitches look on that one, so I think I restarted it, and that's when I started Fairy Idol 2, so it didn't look weird when I look at it now, but because I took pictures of it and I have it on my Instagram. But for whatever reason, I really didn't like it then. So I think I started like 3 or 4 times on each of those projects. And now I look at it, it doesn't really look different. It looks exactly the same. So I don't know why I was so stressed about how my cross stitches looked. But yeah, that's the worst one. Like, I don't really have a bad experience with cross-stitching. Next question. 12. What do you love and what do you hate about cross-stitch? What I hate about cross-stitch is that some of the charts goes, it's out of print and they don't make them anymore, and it goes up. Like, the price goes up so high on eBay. That's what I hate about cross-stitch patterns, or about the whole cross-stitch print out of prints. But I mean, I understand why that happens, but sometimes it sucks when you want something and then, like, it's priced up so high that you can't get it even though it's on sale. Like it's available to be purchased. I couldn't find the Nightmare because it was out of print. Those are out of prints, right? But I found a Etsy shop who sold it, so I got it for a reasonable price, which I wasn't mad about. But other than that, yeah, there's nothing I hate about cross stitch. Okay, I think I'm gonna stop right here because I don't know how far, because it cut the charts goes into the next page. I'm gonna end my thread here for now. What I love about cross stitch, I have no answer for that either, because I just like to cross stitch, but I still haven't been able to explain why. I think I just like the process of making something, because I'm also a metalsmith. I make jewelry and other things. So I'm always making something, and cross stitching is also a process of using my hands to create something. So I think that's what I like about cross stitching, the process. Number 13. Have you introduced anyone else to cross stitch? I have, but it didn't really stick. Like, I told my best friends from college about cross stitching, and they already knew about it, but then they were like, oh, I wanted to try, but I haven't. And then I think they even got a kit, but I never saw them actually stitching them. Other than that, I don't think... Yeah, no. Not many who I told them about cross-stitching and who actually got into cross-stitching. Number 14. Like here, this is what I'm saying, like this part right here, I'm doing the half stitch, and this is gonna be one line, but then this is gonna be like this patterned line. I don't know what to do. I think I'm just gonna keep on going that way. Like right here, that's what's happening here also. But still, give me your opinion about it, if it looks bad or not, or should I just do a full cross stitch on those areas? Anyways, number 14. What was your first project and did you finish it? If not, what was your first finish? Yeah, I don't remember my very first project, but I could show you one of my earliest finishes. I made it into a pillow. I didn't make it into a pillow, someone else did. There was a little shop where I used to live when I was in middle school, and there was a lady there who could make it into a pillow, and all I had to do was tell them what kind of fabric, or not what kind of fabric, what color fabric, and she would just choose the pattern of the fabric, and she will make it into a pillow. But I'll insert a picture here. And I talked about this project in my other videos that I deleted. But I think I made that in middle school for a class where it was a kind of like a club, like a cross stitch club. So it happened every other Saturday morning, like 8 till 12, and it was mandatory for everyone to participate, not to cross stitch club, but there were other clubs also, but I signed up for the cross stitch club. So that was my first, I think, first finish. And then the second one, I'll insert a picture here also. This one I did after the first one. But I went to the same shop and got that finish into a pillow. And I only told her I wanted red fabric, and she chose those. And it was really affordable for me to get it done that way. I think it was only like 15,001, so about $15 to $17, I think. But that shop is not there anymore. I don't know when, but it changed into like a antique shop while I was in the States. Last question. How do you store your cross-stitch floss? I bobbinate them. I don't have the full collection of the DMC yet, but I store my floss for each project in these floss box. So this one is for the Rose Quaker that I'm stitching right now. And then I have this one right here. This one is for Stone Roses. So I keep them in here like this. And I have the symbols on top. But the ones that I'm not using in a project, I have it into a bigger box. And everything's bobbinated and organized by its number. So that's the end of my original cross stitch tag. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments and I'll try to